NASCAR fans at Texas Motor Speedway were treated to a small taste of the action this afternoon. Many of the team's car haulers began arriving at the Speedway, so fans watched as the trucks lined up on the street waiting for their turn to park near the garage area. NASCAR race weekend draws a crowd four times larger than any Cowboys home game, and this year's races come at the height of severe weather season, and there is a slight risk of severe weather tomorrow. Chief Meteorologist Dan Henry joins us now live from TMS with his forewarned special report. Dan?
Heather, through its 10-year history, Texas Motor Speedway has had a pretty remarkable record. Only one significant injury due to the weather. A man struck by lightning a couple of years ago, but I'm told he's doing pretty well. But sooner or later, Texas Motor Speedway may be hit head-on by powerful straight-line winds, large hail, or possibly even a tornado. So how susceptible are race fans here? And how prepared is TMS to keep them safe?
Got debris falling.
Spring in North Texas, notorious for nasty weather. Like the 1995 Mayfest storm that killed 17 people.
Mayfest was certainly a wake-up call for anyone involved in planning an outdoor venue this time of the year.
And outdoor crowds don't get any bigger, a quarter million strong, than race weekend at Texas Motor Speedway.
When you get a group of people together that's this large,
the man in charge of TMS, Eddie Gossage, has to be ready for anything.
Somebody's going to have a heart attack. Somebody's going to have a baby.
But his ultimate challenge is staying on top of the tumultuous Texas weather, like the Fort Worth tornado in 2000.
We were watching them immobilizing, prepared to send the police into the campgrounds. That was early in the week, but there were still some campers here, so they could go through with their PA systems on their cars and tell people to seek shelter.
The strong F2 tornado hit downtown Fort Worth. Had it formed 20 miles farther north, the track could have looked like this. The Atlanta Motor Speedway was broadsided by a half-mile-wide F2 tornado last July. The twister peeled away entire sections of the grandstand and left luxury boxes in ruins. Luckily, there was no race that night.
In 1987 in West Memphis, Arkansas, we had a dog track with 7,000 fans in attendance. A rain-wrapped tornado moved one quarter mile from that dog track at night. They never knew it.
Severe weather expert Roger Edwards says it's just a matter of time before disaster strikes at a place like TMS.
The potential is there for the largest tornado casualty in U.S. history.
We've got an emergency plan that's a written emergency plan. It's about an inch thick.
Eddie Gossage says he's well aware of the potential threat. The Speedway uses trained storm spotters who monitor Doppler radar 24/7. And he believes, if necessary, every fan in the grandstands and infield can be safely sheltered.
There's more than 100 different buildings on the grounds. Concession stands, souvenir stands, restrooms, the garage.
During race week, as many as 40,000 people will be camped out here in the infield. Now, some will flock to the buildings in the infield, but many others will find shelter at either end of the racetrack in one of these tunnels.
Al Mohler's one of the best in the business at tracking and forecasting North Texas storms. He's very concerned about the fans camping around the racetrack.
Anybody who's out here camping is going to have a high level of situation awareness. They're going to have to always know what's in the weather forecast.
He says it was very wise to install two tornado sirens at TMS, but that may not be enough.
Once that siren sounds, as many as 40,000 people in RVs, tents, and trailers may only have precious minutes to react. Out here, they'll have to navigate through a sea of vehicles, possibly in the dark, all the way to the racetrack. And that's a half mile away.
Joanne Black camps here every year.
We have to be self-sufficient out here.
Her RV is equipped with satellite TV and internet access to keep her a step ahead of the storms.
We want to make sure we got good weather for the race weekend.
Yeah, absolutely.
But if that good weather turns bad, she has a plan. There's a ditch just a few steps away. Or if there's time, she'll head for the racetrack tunnel across the parking lot.
There's lots of places that are safe. It's just a matter of thinking ahead.
Time is a precious commodity in that situation. Time to prepare, time to get to a place of shelter.
Al Mohler points out that TMS is certainly not the only vulnerable spot in North Texas. He cites a recent study that looked at what would happen if an F5 tornado, like the one that hit Oklahoma City in 1999, hit Six Flags in Ameriquest Field in Arlington, then tracked into Dallas at the height of rush hour.
The loss of life might be somewhere in the neighborhood of from 600 to 1,600. deaths with a good warning. There would be so many people caught on the highways, it would just be absolutely disastrous.
Likewise, the highways around the speedway become parking lots around race weeks. But Gossage says that if the track ever does take a direct hit, TMS is as prepared as possible.
You're probably safer here than pretty much anywhere else. Here, we've got an army of doctors and EMTs on site. There's care flight on site to get that person off the grounds when something occurs.
While Gossage and the National Weather Service will do their part to protect the public, they say each person shares that responsibility.
We're going to try and take care of the group, but you need to take care of yourself first and foremost.
And taking care of yourself means using good common sense, and I cannot stress that enough. If it looks threatening to you, don't wait for someone to tell you to take shelter. You go ahead and do it. Stay on top of the weather forecast, use a battery-operated radio, or tune into a TV to catch Fox 4 on one of the thousands of tailgates out here at TMS. Stay safe, and we'll keep you forewarned.